Yo, what's going on? It's D-Man here to bring you some more information on NBA 2K21. I'm starting to put out more NBA 2K21 content, mainly because next gen is around the corner. And when next gen drop, it's going to be a flood of videos, bro. I don't know what I'm going to post. I don't know what next gen is looking like. But from what we've heard so far, next gen is looking kind of tough, man. So in this blog, man, we learned about player builds, badges, and takeover. I mean, we also learned about AI, but we're going to cheese the AI for badges anyway, assuming you still have to do that. So in this video, we're only going to talk about the My Player Builder. Real talk. If you want to read everything, I'll leave a link in the description where you can check out this blog. So let's go ahead and get into it. First off, no more pie charts. Now, what did I think about pie charts? I don't know. You know me, man. We hoop regardless. Pie charts, no pie charts. But I know a lot of people felt limited, and I understand that. But on next gen, we'll be able to customize each individual rating. Of course, there'll be restrictions, but we'll be able to make the player we want to make. And I'll take that. So I'm gonna start off with my slasher build that I have on current gen. And if I can get anything past that, it's a W for me. Like, if I can get contact dunks in a 3, hey, you know I'm hooping. It's funny though, because like, we're getting all this customization and y'all still gonna copy people. Come on, make your player, bro. Make your player, man. So next up, let's talk about badges. Now, a lot of thought and redesign went into badges for next gen. Some of your favorites will return, but some of them are completely different. Now, we still have the same categories, which are finishing, shooting, playmaking, and defense slash rebounding, and you're able to earn badge points in any mode. So earning badges will pretty much be the same concept, but apparently you might want to experiment with some different badges that you may have overlooked, because you might find some new favorites to complement your playstyle. And we saw that going from 2K20 to 2K21. Some badges that were useless in 2K20 were just god tier in 2K21, like flexible release. Nobody used flexible release in 20, but in 21, it's a decent badge. Now in 20, fancy footwork was the god tier badge. And in 21, you don't see it around as much. So of course, next gen will be a new game, and I expect some new badges to be better than others. So let's go ahead and take a look at all of the badges. We have Fearless Finisher, which will boost contact layups and decreases fatigue, which is basically relentless. We have Heat Seeker, which boosts takeover progress on inside shots. Highlight Film, boosts teammates takeover progress on flashy dunks, which is showtime. We have Hook Specialist, which, oh man, that sounds like a pain. Boost hook shot ability. Zilla, get ready. Revive Posterizer, contact dunks. They should just rename that to the D-Man badge. Let's be real. Rise Up, boost ability to do standing dunks in traffic. Antifreeze, harder to get cold and lose takeover meter progress. I like that. Blinders, less affected by peripheral defenders when shooting jumpers. I like that too. We have Circus Threes, which improved the ability to hit pull-up jump shots and step back threes. We have Fade Ace, boost all post fadeaways. Hot Shot, which increases takeover meter faster when knocking down jumpers. I like that they added that too. Now we also have Deep Threes, which is Dame and Curry range three balls, AKA Limitless Range. Hey, shout out 2K for putting respect on Dame name, bro, because everybody talks about Curry range. Dame been doing that too. People just found out last season though. It is what it is. We have Rhythm Shooter, which boosts shot percents out of size ups, as well as one step pull ups. I might need that. Set Shooter, shooting ability gets better the longer you sit and wait for pulling. I might need that too. Sniper, boost the ability to hit shots when using the pro stick aiming. Bro, man. Is the pro stick aiming not the reason for all these modded controllers going around right now? I'm not too sure, but if it's the case, bro, like, I think pro stick aiming needs to be scrapped if that's the case. I don't know. I'm not too sure. So just enlighten me in the comments and let me know. We have Stop and Pop 3 for the JJ Redis who wants to pull up for threes in transition, aka the CKZ badge, even though the dunk is wide open. Bullet Passer gives you the ability to throw laser dots like LeBron. Relay Passer boosts the shooter on pass to assist situations. I'm rocking that. I'm a demon at that. Special Delivery boost takeover progress for the passer and receiver off of flashy pass assists, ankle braces, makes it tougher for ball handlers to break your ankles, clutch defender, boost your defensive ratings in clutch moments. I rock with that. Boost takeover meter for good defensive plays like steals, blocks, and good contest. Real talk, I'm liking some of these badges. I really am. You're really going to be able to create the type of player you want to create. So now we have to talk about takeover. In case you're new to 2K, takeover is the ability to get hot and take over games. It's been a popular feature for the past couple of years. Of course it's popular, we don't have a choice, but that's cool. It has been popular though. Instead of limiting players to 8 general archetype based takeovers, we've broken those 8 into 24 more specific takeover abilities. In a way, you can think of them as unique badges that you can fire off when you get hot. This is going to be interesting. So the takeover system has changed a little bit. Now we have a multi-tier system. So once again, we have double takeover. So you'll have a primary takeover ability and a secondary takeover ability. Or if you want, you can double up, just like I did with my pure slasher. And I assume that takeover ability will last longer if you double up. When you're in game, your takeover meter will fill up to the primary takeover slot first. Once filled, you can choose to activate it right away or wait to try to fill up your secondary slot. But you have to be careful because if you lose that progress, it goes all the way back down. You know how the takeover meter works. But if you fill up the secondary slot, you can activate both the primary and secondary takeovers. So as always, a little strategy goes into using this takeover. Team takeover is basically the same online and in my career. So it's pretty much what we're used to, we just have more options. Now 2K did decide to honor Kobe Bryant and give us the Mamba Mentality badge. When you earn that badge, it allows you to change your takeovers whenever you want. Very interesting. Throwing that cap on Kobe's name like that. Come on, man. We know we had to get this next gen. We knew we were getting this next gen, and y'all know why. But I like it though. We can change our takeover whenever we want. I'm looking forward to that, for sure. So let's go over some of these takeover badges. Advanced Gathers, which is basically fancy footwork. We have Finishing Moves, able to absorb contact and finish at the rim. Easy Blow-Bys, enhances ability for slashers to beat defenders off the dribble. My type of badge, just call that the D-Man Takeover, you feel me? Pull-Up Precision, boost well-timed slash aim shots off the dribble. Ankle-Breaking Shots, more ankle breakers off of spin and step back jumpers. Negative Impact, reduces defensive impact against pull-ups and other skill shots. Limitless Range, extends your shooting range out to the logos. So we have Limitless and Deep Range. That's gonna be deadly. I might have to make a shooter. If I can shoot like that and get contact dunks, it's over, bro. Don't make me start playing 2K again. The past couple of years, I've just been trolling with the slasher because that's how I have fun. Don't make me do it, 2K. I promise you. Mess around and end up in a 2K league. Not really. Spot Up Precision. Boost well time slash aim stationary jump shots. That's more of my badge. Let me stop capping. Team Ratings Boost. Playmakers boost their teammates' offensive ratings, which is floor general. Team Takeover Boost. Boost your teammates' takeover meter progress. Team Badge Boost. Boost your team's badges upper tier. Hey, that's OD. I need that for sure. Extreme Clamps, which is more stonewall and lost dribble body up resolution for locks. Hope locks aren't OP, but we'll see. We have Perimeter Drop Badge, which knocks shooting badges down a tier when you get close. Sheesh. Enhanced Jump Shot Contest, boost your ability to contest jumpers. Stealth Blocks, unlocks more swap, backboard pins, and grab blocks. I like it. Paint Intimidation, boost your ability to affect shots around the rim. Interior Badge Drop, which drops opposition scoring badges down a tier in the paint. Box Out Wall, improves ability to seal off opponents for easy boards. See the Future, shows where missed shots are going to end up. Then we have Glass Clearing Dimes, which at the rebounds, kick out passes boost your teammate's shooting. We have Power Bat Downs, easier to push defenders around when posting up. Post Playmaking, which boosts your teammates' offensive abilities when passing out of post. Advanced Post Moves, easier to beat defenders with post moves. post shot daggers, increased scoring ability with hooks, fades, shimmy shots, etc. All right, so, man, 24 takeovers seem kind of OD, but I don't know. We'll see how it goes, especially since I see most of these takeovers as badges. So the fact that we're only able to activate them at a certain time will be pretty interesting. So I'm looking forward to building the My Player on next gen. Like I said before, I pre-ordered the Xbox and PS5, so I'll be able to have gameplay up on November 10th, and that should be interesting. I might just stream the Xbox. I'm not going to cap to you. So we'll see how that goes. Let me know what you think in the comments below. You all be easy and take care. Be safe. Peace.